Hello everybody! Tonight I'm going to be showing you some of the RSD records that have showed up. In a previous video I told you about 4 records that I had purchased online, and 3 of them have shown up. They're all by the same artist, so yeah, there's that. As well as 2 films that I picked up within the last couple of days. More on that later. But yeah, I also wanted to introduce you to Matilda. She is my... Do you want to hop on my hand? She doesn't like it when I do that very much, do you? This is Matilda. She is my new cockatiel, and she is a little shit sometimes, aren't you? Yes, you are. But yeah, she's my new best friend. I'm not sure if I'm her best friend yet, but yeah. You wanna go back up there? Okay. There you go. Sorry, it's yeah, a bit touch and go with her because what, do you wanna go up there? There you go. Well, there's that if she wants to go up there. But yeah, I just wanted to meet her. So just in case anyone's wondering, I'm kind of like dolled up because I went out to a pub with some friends that I made at uni, and yeah, I bought this top and I hadn't had an opportunity to wear it. So I yeah, just threw it on, put on some eye makeup, and yeah, that's it. So I just paired it with a pair of jeans, which was kind of a bit, I was kind of a bit shy because there's been a shortage of estrogen pills, so I've had to switch to the patches. And I'll show you the patch. It's not sure if you can see that right there. There's a patch there. That's an estrogen patch. So yeah, I've had to switch to those, and it kind of sticks out a little bit, so I was a bit self-conscious about that. But yeah, I don't know. I went out, had fun. That's all I care about. So yeah, let's get on to the records. So starting with the 3 records that I bought, they're all by the same artist as I said. His name is Ruel, R-U-E-L, not sure exactly how to pronounce that. I'd never heard of him before. He's an Australian singer, and for Record Store Day he released 3 singles on 7-inch vinyl. There's only 150 of each of these pressed, so I got really lucky. They're only released in Australia and New Zealand, and I managed to get all 3, so I'm very happy. Because if you go on YouTube, you can listen to his stuff, including these 3 songs. They're really, really good. They really are. So there's Painkiller. I'll take you through these in a minute. Dazed and Confused. He looks really young in that, because he was only 16 when this one was released in 2018. And As Long As You Care, which is from last year. So yeah. Really lucky to get these, because as I said, only 150 of each of these pressed, and yeah, really, really lucky. And they were $52.90 each, so they weren't cheap. But when you consider how many of these were actually pressed, $52.90 isn't that much. So I'm really, really happy to get these. So let me take you through them all. First one I'll show you is Painkiller. This one here, as you can see, has a really, really cool front artwork. You can see that they've done... like that's not wear on the sleeve. It's actually part of the design. They all have that. They've all got that like wear mark from the record as part of the design, and I think that's pretty cool. So yeah, I really like that. And if we go on the back side, you can see Royal at the top there, Painkiller, the name of the song, and just a bunch of information about the songs and who was involved in it, and the distribution and everything like that. So the sleeves I really like. I think the sleeves have been done really well. And the record itself, each record is a different color to match the artwork. This one here is a translucent yellow, so it looks really, really nice. And the labels look really, really cool too. So yeah, overall I'm really, really happy with these. Next one is Dazed and Confused. This one here, he looks really young in that because this was made when he was 16. He's only 18 now, so this one was made when he was 16. And, well, I mean the song was made when he was 16. So the front artwork here, again, we have the wear of the record itself. Overall, looks really, really good. Bit of a blur there, reflection at the back. So yeah, really, really like the artwork on this one. And on the back here, we have the same as before. But you've got all the information about this particular song. The record for this one is a translucent green. It looks really, really nice. I'm actually a big fan of it. I've never had records these specific colors before, and they look really cool, so I'm yeah, really happy with that. Again, really nice label on it as well, so yeah, really nice. The last one is As Long As You Care. This one here is one of his more recent ones. It was 2020, so really like this one. It's all of these are on YouTube, by the way, if you really want to listen to them. But yeah, it's such a great song, this one. Again, we have the whale. I think they kind of overused the wear ring in the artwork here, but considering these were released at the same time, I guess they wanted them all to match. So yeah, really nice. It's got kind of a, I can't tell if that's 70s or 80s vibe there. I don't know, possibly even 60s, I don't know. Looks more 70s to me. But yeah, really, really nice artwork on this one. Again, on the back, info about the song itself. And the record itself is orange, translucent orange, so really, really nice. Again, label, custom for this one, and yeah, really, really happy with this one. I don't know if it's really relevant, but I recently started working at JB Hi-Fi. Long story short, I shopped there so much I'd, you know, become kind of friends with a guy that worked there, and he told me about this job opening. So I applied for it, got an interview, and I got the job. It's really casual, but you still get the discounts. So, and the discounts are pretty generous. So yeah, it's worked out really well since I buy so many movies. So I bought a couple of films. Godzilla vs. Kong is the first one I'll show you. This was, I think it was about 40 bucks and paid a little bit less than that. I don't know if we're allowed to go into the discounts we get, but yeah, they're pretty generous. So let me take you through this one. Already watched this one last night and kind of I didn't like it, let's just put it that way. It wasn't bad, but it wasn't great either, so it's one of those films. So as you can see, we have all the information on the back of this J card, and yeah, so have a read of that if you'd like. And removing it, really a nice artwork on the front here. You can see Kong and Godzilla going at it in the middle of the building, so yeah. And then you have the Godzilla vs. Kong graphic there, really nice. And you can see around the steelbook too, we have some artwork on sides. And there's the spine there, Godzilla vs. Kong. And on the back here, we have a really nice close-up shot there of Godzilla about to vaporize Kong, I guess you could say. And interesting story in the film about that. I'm not going to spoil it for anyone if you want to see this, but there's an interesting ending. And opening it up, we have the 4K and Blu-ray in here. Very happy to see they're still including a Blu-ray, because there's nothing worse than not having a 4K player, because there's two TVs here and sometimes someone's using the main TV. And rather than unhook the player, I like to just use the Blu-ray. And yeah, so it's really good when they have that there. But you can see on this disc here, the 4K has Godzilla's foot there. I don't know if that's his, is that his actual foot? No, I think that's his, I think that's his foot. I don't think it's a footprint. So there's Godzilla's foot, and there's Kong's foot. So yeah, really nice. And the artwork on this thing is insane. See Godzilla and Kong on an aircraft carrier battling it out, and that honestly, those fight scenes in this, they were the best parts of the film. I really, really enjoyed those. If you got a decent surround sound system, it's just epic, honestly, absolutely epic. So yeah, overall, the steelbook on this, it does look amazing. I'm really happy with the steelbook. The film itself, as I said, it has its moments, but yeah, it's not the best film. The first film has been my favourite, and it is still my favourite. So yeah, it's a really nice steelbook. I really love it. It's actually one of the better steelbooks that I've seen. So I'm really happy with the overall presentation here. It's just the film that was kind of a letdown. It's one of those big blockbuster movies that doesn't really... It's not really about the story. It's about how visually spectacular it is, I guess you could say. So from that point of view, it was actually really good, but from a story point of view, I didn't really enjoy it. It was mainly the big battle scenes that kept me hooked. So yeah, next one I'll show you is Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory 50th Anniversary Collector's Edition. This one here, it retails for about 80 bucks, And again, I got a generous discount. So I'm really, really happy about that. And I wasn't actually aware that there's two different versions of this that look almost identical. There's this one, and then there's one that you can get off Zavvi, which has a different, like you can see inside here, right there, you've got like a Wonka bar in a box there. The one that I've seen on YouTube people reviewing, the box is really like thick and sturdy. I'll just take you through it and I'll explain it when I get there. So as you can see, we have a really sticky, kind of a J-card-y type thing, C-card, I don't know what they call these ones. But it was, you can see on the cover here, there's still sticky stuff on it because this thing was ridiculously on there. There's the info on the back there if anyone wants to read through that, you can pause the video. And here is the outer slipcase. There's the back of it. Really nice artwork. There's the side there, and other side, same stuff. And here's the front artwork. So removing this, you have this chocolate bar, you know, Wonka bar, sort of case that holds everything. And this is what disappointed me. You can get ones that have, it's a really thick, like sturdy case that I've gotten with a lot of other Zavvi stuff. And it looked like the same edition. It's basically the same edition. It's just this particular Wonka bar box. It's, you know, just like a cheap, flimsy, like, you know, box thing. So I wasn't too happy about that, and I may possibly buy one of the other ones just to get the better box and maybe sell this one if it isn't any different. Don't think it is. I think it's just this one here, but Okay, starting with the film itself, has a standard 4K case here, there's information on the back, and we have the discs itself. The difference I have noticed about this one is the discs themselves. With the Zavvi one, I've noticed that the Blu-ray is actually a blue disc, but the 4K is the purple one, so I have noticed that. And but other than that, pretty nice, standard 4K case there. And so next thing I'll show you is the booklet. You can see the booklet here, there's the back of it, it's the front, and this is just filled up, there's Gene Wilder, I think that's how you pronounce it. So just a really nice book with a lot of information about Roald Dahl, the individual characters, Gene Wilder, Jack Albertson, you know, just a bunch of information about the cast. So I think this is like really well done. And then there's some, lyrics here. So you can sing along with the songs if you want. I love those songs personally. I love singing to them. So, really, really nice book there, for people that are interested in it. And if you buy this particular set, obviously you're interested in it. And finally, we have this folder containing all of the posters and, you know, extras that you get. So there's the front of this. Really nice artwork on this folder here. And here's the opening here, Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. So you open it up, and you've got this stuff in there, so let's pull that out. First up, we have a golden ticket. I'm not going to call this a replica because it isn't. It's just a piece of cardboard that has that printed on there. And I say that kind of pissed off because I am. I mean, I knew that this was like this, but I just don't understand why they couldn't just put a real foil like golden ticket in here. I mean, you can't tell me that would have been an expensive thing to do. It couldn't have cost any more than doing this. So but it is a nice, you know, here's a Wonka's golden ticket. Kind of gives you an idea of what it looks like, but having a, you know, proper replica in here, I don't think that would have been a big ask, personally. But there's that. And next we have a replica. Well, I don't know if these are replicas, if they were this small, but it's basically, this is what the original poster looked like when the film was released. So yeah, that's nice to have. I love these things. That's why I buy these sets, because it's nice to, you know, take these out and look at them. And here's the back of it, which I guess was another advertisement from the day. That's pretty cool. And finally, we have the character cards. We have Charlie Bucket. And these are just blank on the back. We got Augustus Gloop. Mike TV. Veruca Salt. And Violet Beauregard. One thing I noticed about these, which is kind of weird, is you can see Charlie Bucket's card is like a kind of darker purple than the rest of the cards. I don't know what's going on there, but it is what it is. And yeah. So that's all I've got to show you guys. Hopefully you enjoyed the video, and I'm gonna leave this one here. Till next time, ciao for now.